Global illumination, which simulates the reflection of indirect light, is one of the key features that makes game graphics realistic. GI light map generation is done automatically with few options and one click. However, there are challenges in the process of improving the quality of light maps. High quality always comes with long computation times and poor runtime performance. I've been reading the Unity docs and trying a few different things to try to solve this problem. I attached the URLs of the documents I referenced in the description. It's not a perfect solution, but I'll give you a method that you can apply. The default light map parameters are presets prepared to support low-end to high-end platforms. These settings are suitable for beginners and experts alike to do simple indirect light tests. Let's compare the results. You can see that the quality of indirect lighting varies depending on the settings. However, there is little change in quality except in places where the indirect light is close to the ground. Global settings are convenient, but we know that a lot of calculations are being performed in places where quality improvement is not needed. By involving the GPU in the generation of light maps, we can expect to see a time reduction, but the higher the quality, the longer it takes to bake. There is also the problem of the number of textures increasing because the UVs of the object are widely used in a limited texture size. This is because the number of image samples increases as the number of textures increases. We need to modify the light map baking environment to improve efficient light map generation and performance. Comparing the density of clusters generated for each setting, we can see that there are many unnecessary calculations in areas where quality improvement is minimal. Therefore, it seems preferable to create a small number of clusters in places where precise indirect lighting calculations are not required. Let's take a look at the mesh renderer component of a 3D object. If you look at the light mapping tab, you will see the light map parameters option. Scene default parameter is applied. This refers to the global light map parameters applied to the light mapping settings. Changing this option allows you to apply per mesh light map parameters. The area that needs to be baked at high resolution is only a small portion of the overall scene. If so, most areas don't need the precision of light map calculations. Therefore, I'm going to set the resolution of the global custom parameters extremely low. Since the size of the texels per unit will be very small, I will set the cluster resolution value to 1. If you set the value below 1, the cluster size will become too large. If you are not familiar with custom light map parameters, I recommend using the default low resolution parameter. Next, I will apply the separate custom light map parameter to meshes that require high quality indirect lighting. Alternatively, you can apply the default high resolution parameter. Finally, if you look at the real-time lighting group in the lighting tab, you will see an indirect resolution option. This option has the same functionality as the resolution of the light map parameter. However, indirect resolution works globally and works with light map parameters. The number of clusters and the size of the texel are determined by multiplying the indirect resolution, and cluster resolution. In this video, I will start with the default value of 2 texels per unit, or per meter. Meshes in areas that are less affected by indirect lighting and use partial real-time lighting may not need light maps. By disabling Contribute GI for that mesh renderer, you can prevent the number of light maps from increasing while improving their quality. Also, if there is no difference compared to whether light maps are applied or not, I recommend boldly disabling this option. You can see that the result is the same as using the global high quality parameter, but the number of textures is reduced compared to before. If you look at the texture, you can see that it contains a lot of UVs in one texture thanks to the small size of the texels used. This becomes clear when we look at the clusters. We can see that the mesh splits are extremely small in order to create a small number of clusters. This means faster light map generation times as well as improved runtime performance. When creating a scene containing many 3D objects, you may need more than 3 light map parameters. Creating good quality and optimized light maps takes a lot of effort. Please try to create efficient and optimized light maps by appropriately distributing quality gain and loss as in this tutorial.